Right, now moving to a more comfortable position on the floor. Perhaps move back to standing soon. But see how it goes. This hand is kind of sweet. So, some notes on Simeon. It's a little bit of a random card, but I think that its power level is worth it. Like, the card is good in a variety of shout out. Thanks, yo. The card has been great in a variety of different kinds of decks that have basically nothing in common except they can use red mana. Like, I think not playing it is probably a mistake. Okay, so we're playing against this deck. It doesn't have an amulet. Not very too scary over there. Serum Visions, alright. Well, we should get the Sylvan Caryatid out. Opponent can't deal with it. And we need the blue mana, so. There's a lot of Serum Visions. We're a ways from making Dig Through Time happen. But the opponent's hand looks pretty slow, and we've got some draw steps ahead of us, as do they. Oh, there's an amulet over there, so that's really scary. But, I guess I'd be happy to play another Caryatid. There's not really a way to Izzet Charm the Summer Bloom, but the opponent currently has nothing that is a Primeval Titan, so that's good. They drew an amulet and they drew a card this turn. And yeah, basically their hand is just full of mana. So they can get all their mana into play this turn. But if they didn't draw a Primeval Titan or a Summoner's Pact, then it doesn't really matter too much. Radiant Fountain, this thing's getting a lot of life though. Can Summer Bloom? Does not. Alright, here's a Conclave. So, we could leave up Izzet Charm and wait on the Serum Visions. I don't know what Izzet Charm's gonna catch. Probably nothing. So I'd be more interested in playing Serum Visions. We can maybe use our mana this way. We could keep up Izzet Charm and loot, and that would have been reasonable. Alright, both these cards are good because they're gonna power our Dig Through Time. So, could Izzet Charm to kill the Azusa, but that doesn't seem super relevant. Playing Fairy Conclave is pretty scary. Question is whether we would want an Izzet Charm to loot. Let's think about our mana here. We have two cards in the bin. Next turn we'll draw Thought. Metamorphose is 3 and the Thought Scour is 6. Pretty tough call, really. Well, I'm just going to gamble and put the Conclave into play. Hope to not be dead. Again, the opponent's had the last draw and this coming draw right now. Two draws that basically need to be Titans or nothing's happening. Okay. And that's what's happened has been nothing. So here's a cool thing about our deck now is everything is an instant, so we can wait the turn and then decide how to play this. We have Metamorphose and a Thought Scour and a Dig Through Time. And then from there we have a pretty solid shot of hitting a Jeskai Ascendancy and just winning. 6, and we have a little bit of mana of Izzet Charm if we need to. Okay, end of turn. So this version is definitely slower, but I mean, we haven't exposed anything to removal, which I guess hasn't been relevant. Blue, red, Thought Scour, us. There's a Gitaxian Probe, 3, 4, so it would have made sense to do the stuff as a sorcery, maybe. Alright, play this for 4. 1... 2, 3, 4. We'll get 7 cards. I see a Jeskai Ascendancy. I also see a disrupting shoal. Is that worth having? Like, it doesn't draw a card, so I guess I'm gonna take the sleight of hand. And it doesn't seem like we need it. It seems like we're pretty safe to combo off. There's another dig through time. All right. White, blue, red. Play this thing. Tap for blue. Tap for blue. Play Gataxian Probe for life, just to check. Stack these. Use this ability. Sure. Pitch Fate Stitcher. Untap. Take a look. See if there's anything scary. No, there's nothing going on there. So let's just win this as fast as we can. Unearth this. Untap Conclave. Tap Conclave. Make it a creature. Tap for a blue and a blue. Play Sleight of Hand. Use this ability. Pitch Caryatid. Untap these. Use Sleight of Hand. Grab Aseram Visions. We haven't played a land, have we? Blue. Okay, opponent scoops. So that's pretty cool. What was this? Turn 5, which isn't the fastest, but we did have Izzet Charm up at points, and we had protection if we needed it, and we didn't really expose anything to anything, so that's kind of how this deck plays. So the opponent is going to have Seal of Cleansing or whatever. They're going to have a 2-mana enchantment that they can sack to kill an artifact or an enchantment. Probably. That's what I would expect to see. So I like Disrupting Shoal because if we counter Amulet of Vigor, it can be really hard for them to get going. I don't think we'll see Young C Pyroclasm or anything from them, so I'd be tempted to bring in Young Pyro. I'm not a huge fan of Wear Tear, and Izzet Charm is just kind of average, I think. Spell Pierce is not really what we want. Yeah, I'm really not in love with Izzet Charm here. It doesn't. Well, it can counter things, obviously. But it's kind of a tough sideboard here. Question of whether we want the Young Pyros. I don't think we want the Young Pyros because it's pretty hard to actually stop Primeval Titan from coming down. We don't have any sixes for Disrupting Shoal, so I would say let's not play Young Pyromancer. And I'd be interested in mostly keeping it the same, but I want to Disrupting Shoal Amulet because that's usually the problematic card. I'm thinking about, I just heard her water broke Thursday night, just came in from the window through the other street. The mic probably didn't catch that up, but it's like, all right, well, what's going on with her then? How's that going? Anyways, we could cut an Izzet Charm. It's nice to have interaction. And I'd actually like to have more twos if possible. So we can probably cut one Fate Stitcher. And then just gonna cut a Spirit Guide on the draw. I don't know. It's kind of random. I didn't have a plan for this combo deck.